Hello, my students of class 7 and welcome back to your online classes. Today also we will be continuing with the supplementary reader, and the chapter that we started was bringing up Kari. We already learned about how a baby elephant comes to the house of the narrator, and the narrator and the baby elephant has a very good bond. Okay, both of them forms a very deep friendship. The narrator used to take up all the responsibility of raising the elephant, and he also tells us how he would collect different kinds of food for the elephant. Okay, so today we would be continuing the text, and take out your supplementary reader book, take out page number 9, take out a pencil. Let us recapitulate at what point did we leave. So we understood that the narrator and Kari would go to the riverside, and the narrator would clean him, rub him clean using the river sand, and then after that the elephant would lay in the water for a long time. Okay, and he would enjoy his bath time. After he got up from the water, his body would be shining like ebony. Okay, it would be very beautiful to look at. Now, one such day, the same thing happened with them. That means the regular habit that the narrator and Kari had, they repeated the same thing. And then the narrator left the elephant on the edge of the forest and went inside the forest to look for delicious twigs and saplings, luscious twigs and saplings. Remember, the narrator emphasized to us or told us that Kari would reject if any of the twigs were badly cut. Okay, so he took a very sharp hatchet and he took left Kari at the edge of the forest and went inside. Right, now something happened as he was cutting the twigs. He was on the branch of a tree when he heard the sound of the elephant crying for him. The sound of the elephant seemed as if he was in a position of distress. So the narrator quickly came down from the tree and went in search of Kari. But when he got there, he found that Kari was not there. Kari was not in the place where he had left him. Now let us come back to the chapter and let us study. I looked all over, but I could not find him. I went near the edge of the water and I saw a black something struggling above its surface. Okay, he could see that Kari was there in the water. He could not understand exactly it was Kari, but he could feel that something black was there and it was struggling above its surface. That means from the water level, something black was trying to come up. Okay. Then it rose higher, and it was the trunk of my elephant. Then that black something rose higher, and it was actually the trunk of Kari. I thought he was drowning. The narrator thought that for some reason Kari had got down into the water and he was drowning. I was helpless because I could not jump into the water and save the 400 pounds of him, since he was much higher than I. Okay, so please underline this portion. I was helpless because I could not jump into the water and save the 400 pounds of him. What does this mean? Well, why did the narrator think that he would be helpless if he got down in the water in order to try to save Kari? Well, he felt helpless because he understood that Kari was of such a huge weight. He was of 400 pounds. It was something very large compared to the weight and power of narrator. Okay, so he won't be able to help him to get up from the water. So he felt helpless. So if I ask you, why did the narrator feel helpless, as he understood that the elephant, his pet elephant, was probably drowning? Well, you will answer that he felt helpless because he understood or he realized that he would not be able to save the elephant from drowning because he was so much more heavier than him. Okay. But I saw his back rise above the water, and the moment he caught my eye, he began to trumpet. Well, trumpet is the sound made by elephant. You all have learned about it when you were young. What is the sound made by an elephant? It's called trumpet. Okay, so I was helpless because, okay, but I saw his back rise above the water, and the moment he caught my eye, he began to trumpet and struggle up to the shore. Then he could understand that his back was also rising, not just the trunk, but the back of the elephant was also rising above the water. So maybe it was a chance, it was a sign that the elephant was going to survive after all. It was going to get up from the water. Then the elephant saw his master and he looked at him and he started making sounds of happiness. Okay, he was trumpeting and he was trying to struggle up to the shore. He was trying to get up to the shore. Then, still trumpeting, he pushed me into the water. And as I fell into the stream, I saw a boy lying flat on the bottom of the river. Now, the elephant got up from the river. Okay, he got a bit up, and instead of getting up on the river bed, he pushed the narrator into the water. He wanted the narrator to see that someone was there who needed his help. And it was not possible for Kari alone to help that boy, because he saw that a boy was lying flat on the bottom of the river. On the river bed, a boy was already, he had already drowned. Okay, he was lying flat, probably not breathing also. So Kari wanted the narrator to see that the boy was there who needed his help. And as I fell into the stream, I saw a boy lying flat on the bottom of the river. He had not altogether touched bottom, but was somewhat afloat. That is, he was still a bit afloat, floating. Okay. I came to the surface of the water to take my breath, and there Kari was standing, his feet planted in the sandbank, and his trunk stretched out like a hand waiting for mine. Okay, so Kari, just imagine, so intelligent he is. He had already made a plan how to save the two boys. That means he knew that the narrator would try to get up, get the drowning boy to out from the water. Okay, and he knew that Kari's help was required. So he had outstretched his trunk and he was standing with his feet planted in the sandbank. Okay, he was standing very firmly and his trunk was stretched. His trunk was stretched so that if the narrator needed help, he could simply get hold of the trunk and get out from the water. Okay, so Kari was very intelligent as well. I dived down again and pulled the body of the drowning boy to the surface. But not being a good swimmer, I could not swim ashore, and the slow current was already dragging me down. So the narrator was not a very good swimmer. He could simply manage to swim. So he was able to take the boy out from the bottom of the river. Okay. But he could not get back to the shore because he was not a very good swimmer. He had to swim for the both of them. Okay. That means that boy was not able to swim. He was already unconscious probably. And his own weight was there as well as the boy's weight. So he was not able to pull both of them ashore. He was not able to swim that well. So he could understand that the slow current of the river was taking them away from the shore. Seeing us drift by in the current, Kari, who was usually slow and ponderous, that means he was usually very slow and ponderous, that means he was somebody who would think about taking a step and then take the step. He was usually of that person, personality. That means Kari was a slow animal, okay? He wouldn't do anything drastically. But at that moment, he was not like that, okay? In times of need, he was completely different. Who was usually slow and ponderous. That means usually Kari was very slow and thoughtful and wouldn't do anything very fast. Suddenly darted down like a hawk and came halfway into the water where I saw him stretch out his trunk again. So instead of thinking what to do in the situation, Kari took a chance and he suddenly darted down. He came forward in a very fast fashion like a hawk and came halfway into the water. Okay, he could understand that the narrator might not be able to save the boy or even himself. So he came down to the water, he jumped in front of them, tried to help them come back. He raised up my hand to catch it and it slipped. Okay, he tried to catch the trunk of the elephant but it slipped. I found myself going under the water again, but This time I found that the water was not very deep. So I sank to the bottom of the river and doubled my feet under me and then suddenly kicked the riverbed and so shot upwards like an arrow. Those of you who know how to swim will understand this much better than I do. Well, we can understand something that the narrator, as he was not exactly getting the help from Kari, he understood that he had to help himself. Okay, so he again, when he went downwards towards the riverbed, he understood that the bottom of the river was not very deep. Okay, it was not a very deep riverbed in that place. The water was not so deep. So when he sank to the bottom of the river, he just pressed both of his feet. Doubled his feet means he pressed both of his feet against the sand bed, against the river bed, and then he jumped. Okay, he pushed the river bed and jumped upwards like an arrow. In spite of the fact that I was holding the drowning boy with my hand, as my body rose above the water, I felt a lasso around my neck. In spite of the fact that he was holding the drowning boy, he was able to make that gesture. Okay, he was able to jump up from the riverbed and come up towards the surface of the water. And as his body was rising, the trunk of the elephant tried to save him. Okay, Kari tried to save him. So the narrator felt a lasso around my neck, like a rope. Okay, like a rope. He tried to save the drowning boy. This frightened me. I thought some water animal was going to swallow me. Okay, he thought that probably it was some kind of wild creature or some kind of creature which lived in the water. It was going to eat me alive. But it was actually the trunk of Kari, right? And so Kari was actually trying to pull him up using his neck. Okay, he just got his trunk again around the neck of the narrator and then he tried to get him up from the water. I heard Kari squealing and I knew it was his trunk about my neck. He pulled us both ashore. Okay, so it was actually the trunk of Kari and nothing else. It was not any strange sea creature or river creature which was trying to swallow the narrator, but rather Kari who was trying to save the narrator. Okay, so he pulled us both ashore. Both the boy and the narrator were saved because of Kari. So Kari, being such a small young elephant, had so much intelligence and he had so much bravery. Okay, he understood the situation. He wanted the narrator to act out. Now this is something which we even don't find in humans. Okay, we are such developed creature as we call ourselves. Our brains are much more developed. But still, we do not have this, not always we have this kind of sympathy or empathy for our fellow beings. But this animal, he showed us a great moral. He showed us a great virtue. That is, you should always think of those in need. So, Kari gave us a very good lesson. Okay, by trying to help the drowning boy. Okay, so let us stop over here. Read the entire story on your own. Find out the problems which you have. Next day we would be continuing with the next part of the story. Okay, study well.